I'm Carolee Schneemann, and I'm here at MoMA for a little interview while I'm installing a large diptych drawing. Up to Including Her Limits was originally inspired by a neighbor who came to prune my apple tree. I had been working with 3/4-inch mineral rope in creating an aerial suspended kinetic work, and then the tree trimmer went away to have lunch, and I just took off my clothes and crawled into the harness to see what it felt like. The work demands a release of submission to the sense of float that I have being suspended, and then the physical extensivity of the arm with the crayons that are going to keep, as I move, hitting the adjacent walls that are situated so that they're within the reach of the hand with the crayon, as well as the floor. It's a work that developed over the course of 6 or 7 years. I kept adapting the rope and the harness and the time duration to various spaces that I would live in and sleep in, and sometimes even have my cat living with me in the museum. It's usually 4 to 6 monitors, and the various action sequences come from 7 or 8 different performances. Part of my fondness for Up to Including Her Limits is that it relates to the fact that I'm a painter. I have never described myself as a performance artist. When I started extending materials into real time and literal space, it was coming out of the happenings. I was influenced by Claus Oldenburg, by Jim Dine, by Robert Whitman, and it had nothing to do with self-confession or self-exposure or personal narrative. It really had to do with a painterly sense of an environment as a collage arena. Up to Including Her Limits really is in discussion with Jackson Pollock to vitalize the whole body as stroke and gesture in this dimensional space.